about 6 o'clock in the evening. I was coming out to get some foodstuffs. So when I got to the junction, close, almost close to the roundabout, the junction, the bridge there, close to where those men that are selling fishes and lobster, I got there, I was buying, I had a gunshot, the first one. So the second gunshot, that was the one that pierced to my leg. And I didn't know the first time that something has happened to me. So when they say they are shooting, let's go back. As I was about going back, I couldn't move backward again. That was when I noticed that something has happened to me. So my sister that was with me, Mrs. Joy Robert, now held me. She said, "What is happening to you, mommy?" I said, "I can't walk anymore." I said, "It seems the gun touched my leg." So when she turned, really, behold, it was a gunshot. I now confronted the guy. As I was lying on the ground, I told him that you shot my leg. He didn't answer me. The guy is tall and black. He didn't answer me. He left. He was still going forward. That is clearing the road. The next thing, we saw the other second person. So a guy now came to my rescue with the lady that was with me, Joy Robert. So the both of them now carried me. He was now telling the guy that your colleague have shot a lady right now. The guy couldn't answer. I said, "So what can I do?" He now left. So that was when they carried me to the keke. We now use the keke to chase their vehicle. They went towards Amasuma Road. So when we got there, we couldn't get it again, but we collected the number, the vehicle number. So that was what happened.
One of my members in my own church, where I was pastoring before, so give a birth to a baby girl. So I said, "You should go and prepare food so that I can send to them." So he now said, "Okay." As he was seeing their friend off, so he took some money so that he can buy some things and send to the lady that gave birth, that was in the hospital. So I was where I was, they just called me, not quite some time. They just called me that my wife had been shot. I said, "How?" I could not explain it. "Where is she?" The voice was silent. So later, a pastor in my compound, Pastor Prince, also called me, said that somebody rushed to the house now, and that my wife is being shot.
I was in my house yesterday. This girl with our own senior sister. Our senior sister sent her to go and sell a periwinkle at the market. After then, in the night, I had the mortar is about to, after seven, said our senior sister sent her to the market to sell. And after then, police van just arrived and then shot a gun. After shooting the gun, bullet enters her two legs. That's what they told me.
I went to Tumbia to buy something, and my foster mother escorted me from her house. As we were coming down on top of the bridge, a policeman was telling the market women to shift, and they parked their van at the entrance of the Imbiama Yanangwa Road. And it was at that process, he started shooting. He first shoot one gun. Feel that he's shooting. The next thing, he started pointing at the woman, "Move!" He started shooting the ground. That's how I found out that I thought I was already injured. I was shouting that I'm wounded. The next thing, my mom said, she said, her leg, I couldn't carry her. So I have to shout for keke, people to come out to assist me from that place. We even tried to get the van. We saw the van. I said, the police guys have shot my mom. He said, "It's not me." The policeman said, the officer said, "It's not him, that he's the one that did it." And he was just running, and the van also ran. We tried to get the police van. It's a terror pole. I'm forgetting I wrote it down. Is with me, and I want justice to be done to my mom and the other people that have been victim for this police, because their police own is becoming too much on this Yanagwa and all the Nigeria. I want justice to be done, because if they do not punish any of them, they will continue doing what they are doing.
Procedure so far, we just cleaned and debrided the wound for x-ray this morning to know the extent of the bone involvement and then possible surgery after that. Think she'll be needing some external fixation, yes. Their legs. The first victim bilaterally, an avulsion injury on one leg and then a bruise on the other one. Then the other lady's house was quite extensive, a comminuted fracture. So the x-ray will tell us the extent of the bone involvement. But when debriding yesterday, we could see some bony pieces on the leg as we were debriding yesterday. So yes, the second victim's house was very extensive. Surgery, yes, possibly, yes. But the comminuted fracture, she should be able to walk again, yes. Though she will be immobile for a very long period, possibly very, very long period. But yes, she should be able to walk again. Okay, but I'll laugh.